Hello, dear viewers. Welcome to this tutorial on how to limit teenage dressing automatically in Google Mapper. We'll start by giving a brief explanation of what teenage dressing is all about. We'll open the shutter topography mission worldwide elevation data. We'll analyze the two methods of creating water shirt. We have the streaming with cell count, and we have the streaming with drainage area. First of all, what is a drainage basin? It is simply a land area that drains water into a single body, such as a stream, lake, or a wetland. This is a picture of a drainage basin. You have the precipitation, you have the tributaries, you have the watershed divider, and you have the regulations. Component of a drainage basin, you have the precipitations. These are simply the water sources. You have the tributaries, which are stream or river that flow to larger rivers or lakes. You have the watershed divider, which is a line between land whose drainage flows toward our given stream from land whose drainage flows away from our given stream. You have percolation, which is the movement of water through the soil and its layer as a result of the force of gravity. Why do we limit a drainage basin? We simply limit a drainage basin in order to know its physical characteristics, like the surface area in kilometer square, the perimeter in kilometer, the maximum altitude, that is the maximum Z, the minimum altitude, the minimum Z, the average slope, expressed in fraction or percentage, the flow length, which will help us to calculate the flow rate in meter cube per second. So let us limit our drainage basin. We'll open our drainage working zone. This is the shape file and open. So this is the region which we want to limit our drainage basin. So the next step now is to open the online data elevation, that is the SRTM, the SRTM worldwide elevation data. We have two of them. We have the one in 1 arc second resolution and the other one in 50 arc second resolution. The one with 1 arc resolution means the data, the elevation data, are spread apart in approximately 33 meters. Meanwhile, this one, the elevation data, are spread apart in approximately 66 meters. So, obviously, this one is more precise than the second one. So, I will choose the first one. Okay, so this is our data, our elevation data that will be loaded, or simply we can also call it our digital model data. Digital model data, so the digital model return. So I will now simply select, I'll go on editor or the digital data tool. I will select my zone, I'll go on analysis, I will generate my watershed. Remember, we said that there are two methods. We have the first method we can use by streaming cell count, so that you choose the number of cells. You have the second method will be by streaming the drainage area. You put the surface area of the area which you want to limit your drainage basin. So I choose start with the first method. I will see 200 for example, and you shall apply and see how the drainage basin will look like. I will call it drainage basin 1. Take note, you have to crop to the selected area. You come back and you now okay. So you see, this is how our condition has appeared. I can uncheck this data. Uncheck this one. So you see, this is our condition. You have this is our condition has appeared. We can now apply the other because before we complete, let us apply other method. Use other method. I will open it again. I will select my drainage basin. I will go on analysis again once more. Generate and put this one down to drainage 2. I will add the value, let's say to 2000, and we apply. We crop to this little picture and apply and see how it looks like. We can uncheck the first one. you see, size 1 is not the best. You have only 2 floors, so this is not the best. So you can now adopt it. Let me take source 1 and go back to analysis and delete. I use now, I will now apply the third method. This is the second method, sorry, this is the main drainage area where I will put the server 1 kilometer as the surface area, and we crop to the crop and we apply. We call it in a building 3. And like you see, we check this one also is not the best. So it's not the best. So I will now uncheck it again. I check my revision data. I go analysis again once more and see and apply. I'll call the image 4. I will put the size 0.1 and apply. I'll crop to select the feature and OK. Let's check and see and analyze. We see this one. There are many ones in the baby one. I can easily appreciate the result. I have many flows. We have many activities. This one here is going and join this one coming. So I'll adopt this first one. So I'll simply cancel this tree, delete them, and save, and I'll adopt this one as my teenage version. Now let us limit it and in order to obtain the properties. So I will zoom this one. I'll go on polygon. I'll choose polygon. I will limit my image basin and start from here. The same start here. And here like this. And this comes here. Comes here. Now it's inside. Right click now, I will call it a drainage basin. Good. Yeah, area and create the roof property C2. The color I'll take a green skin. Okay. Good. And I verify the projection GM my zone 33 and OK. Can now uncheck everything and check zone back. This is my vision and I check see this is there. The image basin are limited. So let me now high click. I click on it. I'm sure I go back and I click. I go on. So before I click, let me go select. Let me check this one. Then select picture. I'm selecting and open my after page here. I click. I go on analysis management. Analysis management, I go on create, calculate elevation, slope, type for selected feature. Yes, these are all the properties that are created. And okay, I cannot display it so you can see it more clearly. I go on display feature measurement. You see, this is our image basin good. This is the area, this is the perimeter, this is the surface area, the perimeter. You have here the average. The average slope, the average slope in percentage 20-20-20. You have the maximum elevation, you have the minimum elevation, you have an okay. So I can export it to a CSV file in Excel. I'll put it finished this one. And okay. And I close, I go back, I open it in Excel. Then basically, I will change the extension to the ATX. Okay, let me open Excel now. Just open Excel. of the open. Open my drainage basin. Choose all. Drainage basin is here. Okay. Delimited, yes. Next, I'll put only a comma. Yes, and finish. This is my invention. Now I will delete those entities that are not useful. I will add a picture. It's okay. The area is my move it. I can move this one. It's okay. The perimeter. The average slope. The average slope in percentage is value 2. I will delete this one. Now the maximum height. This one will allow the maximum elevation, then the Z max, the Z mean here, so I'll delete this one also. After the Z mean, the mode is going to here, they are useless, so I'll delete them. Okay, now I cannot arrange my picture, information, so I should be clear and put the good name. We have a the watershed. Yes, we have the surface area. The surface area. Yes, we have the perimeter. We have the perimeter. We have the average slope in percentage. As you can see, we have the Z. Z max, and you have the Z mean. I'm going to put it Z mean. Okay, so this one also, and the Z mean is in meta. You put it in it. You have the same here in meta. The percentage, as you can see, even in kilometer, obviously it is only in kilometer, you can see the area and horizon in square kilometer and the drainage basin. Let me save now my data. Save it, I'll put in version, I'll choose the extractor format and okay. Okay, so we see that with this information, it can help us to calculate the flow rate if we know the flow length, and to know the flow length, we simply delete, we insert and measure it from our data. Open, we measure this our flow length. You can choose the longest, we choose the longest side, that's one. Or this one, you can consider this one as a major tributary depending on the length. So the highest length we consider as our flow length, where we calculate our flow rate per in meter cube per second. So that will come to the end of this tutorial. I'm coming very soon with a more precise tutorial on how to limit the drainage basin. This time around, I'll use a different software, Agis, because they have more precise. As you can see, this one has been limited automatically. So in Agis, you shall see how to limit the drainage basin manually. So, and it's more precise, and it is the most recommended method of limiting the drainage basin. So, thanks for watching. And for any worry or for any ambiguities that was not well explained, please do not hesitate to contact us on our channel, the online student academic channel. We will answer you as soon as possible as we connect and receive your message. Stay tuned and do not forget to like and share if this tutorial was helpful.